on Facebook today, my brother-in-law's girlfriend posted something about the weight loss drug Ally, and then my wife wrote something about the side effects, namely the explosive, you know. And so I wrote, with allies like those, who needs enemas? Yes! Best Facebook comment ever! I win! You're on Facebook, Sean? Don't bother. I already win. Funniest comment ever. I'm going to get a trophy. I'm going to change the format of it next week. Everyone will be pissed off and change their status to, I like the old trophy better. Where's my dislike button? Right. Facebook people right there, you are where I will direct my attention to. Very good. Like doing this comedy thing, it's working out for me. I can do this full time because my wife has a job and that's pretty much working for me. My wife has a hard job. She works for the Catholic Church, and I'm not making this up, so don't get offended. My wife works for a center that rehabilitates alcoholic nuns. I swear to God. Real. Alcoholic nuns, lay off the blood of Christ there, Sister Mary Agerbaum. Hard to kick that habit. Yeah. It's two bad puns in the first minute. That's how I roll. Some people open with their best stuff, not me. It's just gonna get better. Just saying, you know you're a nun with a drinking problem when they cut you off in communion. All right, the blood of Christ. Whoa! Whoa! This is your third time through. I do, amen. Just give me the goddamn cup. Hold on a second, this cracker's killing my buzz. There's my saints and apostles. They just had a potluck and know that the nuns can't drink, so I brought jello shots. All right, if you're offended by that because you're Catholic, so am I. On Sunday, I'm going to say I'm sorry and I'm good. That's pretty much how it works out. I checked. I read the book. I didn't read the book. I saw Jesus Christ Superstar like 19 times. Same difference. Whatever. Don't judge me. So we're actually a two-income household because I've asked my wife to get a second job. She works for the American Red Cross. They're doing a blood drive. She told me I should give. And I did because I'm a team player. Plus, I'm afraid of her. Well, my wife is Filipino. And if you guys don't know, because apparently dispatchers can only be white. Filipinos are the scary Asians. Yeah, they're not the back rub, love you long time kind. Those are Koreans. There's a reason you don't see Filipino massage parlors. You want a happy ending, I'm gonna stab you in the neck. I got out of giving blood though, because the next day the nurse went up to me with the needle. She goes, little prick, and I said, ugly bitch. I don't want your blood after that, it's pretty awful. You can use that if you're ever cornered by a nurse, a giant mosquito, or a vampire. Team Edward! Okay, good. Just wanted to see if there were 14-year-old girls in the audience. I wouldn't be complaining, I just wanted to know. So I'm trying to get healthy, I joined Weight Watchers. That's a good place to go to if you want to be hated for having a penis. They did not like men in Weight Watchers. Anyone do the Weight Watchers? Someone back there either packing cigarettes or clapping for that? Awesome. And I wish, do you do the Weight Watchers? It's awful for a guy. I lost 6.5 pounds my first week. Oh, wow. Just like, oh, whoa, whoa. I don't know what that meant. I just, I'm taping this for an audition. Frankly, you just threw me off my game. The rest of you, that's kind of the apathy I met with there, because they do not like the guys. Like the little Nazi Ilsa She-Wolf of the SS instructor's like, I lost 7 pounds my first week. And I'm like, oh, why don't I just pull it out and pee on the carpet? Because I didn't know it was a pissing contest. Then the woman behind me's like, I lost 7 pounds my first week too, and it's easier for men to lose weight than women. I'm like, shut your mouth, bro. Put a chocolate cake in it. I lost 47 pounds overall since Thanksgiving, so thank you. But I got to the point where I lost 10% of my body weight. The instructor wanted me to say something to the class. She's like, well, what's the biggest improvement you've noticed since losing 10% of your body weight? I was like, I don't think you want me to share. And she's like, no, I do. And I'm like, oh, I'm pretty sure you don't. And she's like, share with the class. And I'm like, all right, this looks a lot bigger now. It is awesome. I wake up with a pee boner, I will stare at it for a good 15 minutes. I almost don't recognize it now. I would play with you, but you look like you belong to someone else. I'm almost to the point where I want to start showing it to people. Almost, settle down. It's not gonna happen right now. The only people that would have a before and after to compare it to would be my wife and my doctor, but I want to make a doctor's appointment like you could not believe. He'd be in the examining room like, what's wrong, Mr. Bobbitt? Nothing. Check this out. Dude, this is awesome. I fluffed it. I got it ready for you. It looks like a baby arm. How's that? Not a regular baby arm, but a creepy little deformed arm that doesn't have a hand or anything like that. I mean, it's all I have! So I'm not allowed back to the Weight Watcher meetings anymore. Doing that online. Doing all this to have a kid. I gotta be honest with you, I don't think I'm ready to be a parent yet. No one's gonna argue that with me. You have to be fearless to be a parent. I'm afraid of absolutely everything. Like, I'm even afraid of my basement. Not so much of being down there, I just can't go up my basement stairs without running like I'm being chased. Okay, I'm not alone. And it's not like I think there's going to be an intruder in the house, I'm legitimately afraid of the boogeyman. That's not gonna work if I have kids and one night one of them says to me, hey dad, I think there's something under my bed. I'll be like, oh yeah, probably. Better yours than mine. Tuck your arm and leg inside the mattress so he can't get you. Because if he tags you, you're it. You're going to be sleeping under the bed with the spiders and the earwigs. The real thing is, you know how many spiders you swallow in your sleep bed every night? I don't know. A lot. You'll wake up at school one day and be like, oh, what's this? The third nipple on all these spiders are going to burrow out of your chest like an alien face burger or something like that. And you have an earwig on your cheek. You don't know if it crawled in or crawled out after laying hands on you. Your head's a giant earwig nest now. They look the same frontwards and backwards. That's my point. Guess what? Daddy hasn't changed smoke alarm battery in like 7 years. Let's hope the house doesn't catch fire tonight. Go to school tomorrow looking like Freddy Krueger. Everyone will be like, what happened to you? You'll be like, my dad was too cheap to buy 9-volt batteries. Then no one will want to sleep with you, and they won't be able to because your junk's going to be melted to the inside of your thigh. How about that? All right, Daddy loves you. Sleep tight. Pleasant dreams. Biggest fear of being a parent is having a daughter. I know I'm a nerd. I can't scare a teenage boy if I have a daughter. The only gun I have in my house is sitting in the hands of action figures. How scary am I going to be if I have a daughter, she brings home a guy I don't like, and I'm changing the batteries on a toy lightsaber? You will have her home by 10. Those aren't the boobs you're looking for. At that point, you know the kid's gonna try something just to spite me and be like, some of your house has to get laid because Chubby One Kenobi showed up late.